Hello guys, welcome to Servlet tutorial. Now we shall see one of the session management technique or session handling techniques, that is HTTP cookies. How to handle the session by using HTTP cookies? In the earlier session we have learned about one of the session handling technique, that is hidden form field, or how can you handle the session management or session tracking or session handling by using hidden form field, as well as we have learned about pros and cons, or you can call advantages and disadvantages of hidden form fields, as well as we have gone through the view application, how can I able to track the session from my browser window to my server view application, and there we have created a session by using hidden form fields, as well as we have written some sort of code. Now we shall see about HTTP cookies is one of the session management technique, or it's a second type of techniques. So what is a cookie actually? Cookies are small textual informations which allocates the memory at client side or browser window. Cookies are small textual information which allocates the memory at client side or browser window, or you can call client machine, it has the capability to remember the client data across the multiple requests during a session. So basically cookie is a small text and is allocated the memory at the client machines, and cookies remember the client data across the multiple requests in a session. So to work with the cookies, I need to use HTTP servlets and the protocol, that is HTTP protocol. So there are two conditions are there to work with the HTTP cookies. First is I need the protocol HTTP, and second is I need the servlet of type HTTP servlet. So cookies. So one like hidden form fields, cookies travel over the networks along with the request and response. And one more must and should condition, that is every cookies must be added to the response. Now let me come to the next point. What are the different types of cookies are available? So there are two types of cookies are available. First is in memory, or you can call per session cookies, and second is persistent cookies. So in memory cookies or per session cookies has no expiry time. Also in memory cookies allocates the memory on the browser window. In memory cookies or per session cookies allocates the memory on the browser window. So the meaning is that once the browser window is closed, these in-memory cookies will be destroyed or will be goes off automatically. So let me revise once again. There are two types of cookies. One is in-memory or per session cookies. Second is persistent cookies. In-memory cookies do not have expiry time. So they allocate the memory on the browser window, as well as once the browser window is closed, the in-memory cookies will be destroyed automatically. Whereas persistent cookie contains expiry time, it allocates the memory in the form of files. So it allocates the memory in the files of client machine file system, or you can call hard disks or SSDs, HDD or SSD, and it will be destroyed. Those persistent cookies will be destroyed automatically once the expiry time has reached. Okay, so guys, let us proceed for some other important points about the cookies. So as I said to you, cookie is a small textual information which allocate the memory at the client sites. Okay, so this is the textual informations in the form of cookies. So this textual information contains in the cookies are those the textual information are name, and as also it allows one string value in the form of, you can call, key and value pair. Every cookie contains one name as a cookie name, and it allows one value, string value, that in the form of key and value pair. So every cookie contains cookie ID, or you can call cookie name, cookie ID, and also remembers the web application name or context root name of your web application, or also called as domain name, for which that cookie belongs to. So every cookie should have one unique ID, and also it remembers the web application name, or you can call context name of the web application, and domain name, and that cookie belongs to which application. So next point, the server-side web resource programs of your application. The server-side web resource program of your application create the cookies. So who is responsible to create the cookies? Definitely server-side web resource programs are responsible to create the cookies, and those server-side web resource programs are responsible to add them to the response to send to client window. So because of that reason, cookie allocates the memory as a string information at client side, like for remembering the domain name or web application name. Cookies go back to, so apart from this, cookies go back to web application along with the request when the browser window gives the request to the web application to which cookies it belongs to. As I said to you, cookies travel over the networks in the form of request and response. So cookies go back to web application along with the request when the browser window gives the request to web application to which cookies belongs to. Okay, so one more next point. Cookies also come to client from server, or you can call web application, along with the response as the values of special response header called as setCookie. SetCookie is the response header. What type of response header? Apart from format, method, versions, okay, protocols. So one of the header is setCookie. So setCookie will travel over the networks from the server to browser window. So cookie comes to client from server or web application along with the response as the values of special response header called setCookie. So cookie go back to web application along with the request. Cookies go back to web application along with the request given by the browser window as the special request header values called cookie from web application to browser window cookie, and from client. Cookies come to client from server by using setCookie. So at client side or browser side window, we can see multiple cookies belongs to different domains. So guys, this is basic information about the cookies. In this session, we have learned about what is cookie, and then as I said to you, cookie is a small textual information which allocate the memory at the client side, and it has the capability to remember the client data across the multiple requests during a session. So to work with the cookies, also we need two dependencies. One is HTTP protocol HTTP, and we need HTTP servlet. So cookies travel over the networks as it increases the network round trip, and every cookies must be added to the response. There are two types of cookies. One is in memory and second is persistent cookies. It has some basic information, as well as every cookie contains string values and that need to be added to the response. Every cookie has unique ID which is responsible to remember client ID, or you can call domain name or your application name, and you can remember the cookie name the cookies goes back to client window from server by using setCookie header, and from web application the request header, that is cookie. So this is basic information. Now we shall see what are the basic APIs. We shall see now APIs of working with the cookies, how to create the cookies, how to create, modify, delete, read. Okay,